The COVID-19 virus is currently wreaking havoc around the world and is a pandemic on such a scale that no one in our generation has experienced anything like this before. Scientists are trying to find a vaccine to cure this illness, but best estimates for such a vaccine are more than a year away. At the same time, patients of all ages are suffering, and this is hitting hard for those that are especially over 60 years old. The economic effect on the world of the virus is also beyond comprehension. I am not going to lecture anyone about the virus, the suffering of people, or the effect of the virus on our economy. I am not an expert on any of these subjects, and we are all feeling the effects in one way or another. We are in this together, and I hope that we all come out on the other side healthy. However, I would like to talk about a device that was made in Italy to help patients breathe easier and similar devices that have been proposed and working models made by different institutions. These solutions that have been created all have advantages and disadvantages, and I would like to spend a few minutes explaining what these solutions are and why some are better than others and what I think they should do. These breathing devices use BVM, which stands for bag valve mask, and are also called manual resuscitators, ambu bags, or self-inflating bags. A BVM is a handheld device that is commonly used to provide positive pressure ventilation to patients who are not breathing or not breathing adequately. Make no mistake, even though BVM are handheld devices, they are very complicated. To understand their operation, you need to be very knowledgeable about human breathing mechanisms. By squeezing the bag of this device, oxygen-enriched air is forced to the lungs of the patient. During exhalation, the air coming from the lungs of a patient is kept away from the caretaker toward the face of the patient, as will be shown later with blue arrows. Since there are hundreds of thousands of BVMs around the world, these disposable devices can be a lifesaver for patients who do not have access to advanced and expensive automatic resuscitators devices. The disadvantages of BVM is twofold. The first is that someone must manually place and hold the mouthpiece on the face of the patient. The second is that the same person or a second person must manually squeeze the BVM bag to force air into the patient's lungs. The first problem is easy to address and can be eliminated by adding a strap around the head of the patient and the mouthpiece. To address the second problem, the squeezing of the BVM valve can be made automatic, and there are many applications to do this. Most of them use a stepper motor or DC motors and linkage mechanisms to achieve these. However, these limit the usability of the BVM. My proposed solution uses compressed air without any moving parts. In the animation, the red color indicates high pressure, which makes the inner tubing inflate. The blue color indicates that the pressure is relieved and the inner tubing forces the air out of the system. There are two requirements to achieve this. The first one is that an electric control system activates the 2-way, 3-port pneumatic valve. As the electrical control system, I use an Arduino Uno. The Arduino control and the valve system can be kept away from the patient. The second requirement is the addition of a system around the BVM bag. This jacket-like component will be accomplishing of squeezing the bag. To do this, I am using a PVC pipe as shown in the animation. On the inside of the PVC pipe, I propose the use flexible tubing. Two large hose clamps will firmly attach flexible tubing to PVC pipe ends. There is one inlet at the side of PVC as shown. The compressed air enters from there and has nowhere to go but to make the flexible inner tubing blown away from the inner side of the PVC pipe. This, in turn, squeezes the bag of the BVM. The duration of the squeezing and releasing of the bag will be achieved by the Arduino control system. Since I am over 65 years old and under quarantine, I have nowhere to go to build this system. I hope that someone would build this unit and test it. I am confident that it will work because a friend of mine, acting on my suggestions, did build a prototype and it seemed to have worked. I want to distribute my knowledge of how this system will work so that everyone can benefit from it. I happily assist with the Arduino program and the circuit for anyone who wants to build this system. I will follow up with a video where I will show you how an Arduino controls the valve and explain the important components on it. My only hope is that someone will do this successfully and that this will be useful to relieve some people from their suffering.